Hi everyone, welcome back to another Project Life Process video. I'm really sorry there hasn't been one for the last couple of weeks. If you watch my weekly vlogs, then you'll know that we've been having a bit of a tough time recently with a horrible diagnosis for one of our dogs. So we've just been spending as much time with her as possible, and honestly, like, crafting is the last thing that I felt like doing. But today is the last day of half term, and I sat down this morning and finally put together another Project Life page. This is another double spread, so you will see both pages in this video, and it is April, I believe. So I'm starting with this card. It's both of the dogs dressed up as the Easter Bunny, because I always have to take a silly picture with them for different holidays. And I just used a label there to describe what was going on in the photo, and I wasn't sure of the date, so I've left a space to go back and stamp the date later. This card is the save the date of my brother and his fiance's wedding. There's a little post-it note over the date because they're not sharing the date with anyone who isn't invited. So just in case, I've kept it covered up. And there's a picture below this as well of me holding up the save the date when they came to drop it off at the doorstep. This was way back in lockdown, like towards the beginning of lockdown. And so we were only having like driveway visits with each other at the time. But yeah, I'm covering up the date in that photo as well, so you still can't sneak a peek at it. To put this page together, I've used papers from my stash, but I'm also using some of that Pink Fresh Studio Let's Stay Home collection again. And I'm using the same little tiny alphas that I used on a previous spread. It might have even been the one before this. If it wasn't the one before this, it will be the one before that. So sorry, that's a bit rubbish, but the alphas I found in Hobbycraft, they are just American Crafts thickers, and they are so perfect for Project Life because they're absolutely tiny. And that flower embellishment that I used on the Save the Date card was from the Let's Stay Home collection as well. This is one of the most simple spreads I've put together in my whole album so far. I know I say that every time, but when I looked back at it at the end, and you'll see when I do close-ups, I hardly used any embellishments at all. I think it ends up looking really busy because of all the colour. It's obviously all sort of multicoloured, but it's literally just labels, a few stickers, and a few little wood veneer, and that's like pretty much it, apart from a couple of embellishments from that Let's Stay Home collection. Like this photo here of my brother and his fiance with the save the date, I'm literally just putting on a little wood veneer heart, and that's it. And when I got that heart out of the box, I thought I would add a little wood veneer arrow to that card as well to try and help that save the date stay stuck down, because I used dimensional adhesive to pop up the flower embellishment, and it ended up sort of skewing the card a little bit. So that arrow is helping to keep the save the date secured down. This was something that I found on Facebook or Instagram, I think, way back at the beginning of lockdown. It is healthcare workers, I think it's actually in the US, but they're holding up bits of paper that say, "Stay home so we can make COVID disappear like Carol Baskin's husband." And I know that's not really funny, but at the time I did find it quite funny. And if you don't know who Carol Baskin is, then you need to watch Tiger King. But I just used some embellishments from the Let's Stay Home collection. It's like a little healthcare workers uniform and a little quote card that says something about strength to decorate that, because obviously the healthcare workers have kept the world going during 2020. And I just put a note there about how Tiger King memes really made me laugh at the beginning of lockdown. It's like we went through phases of lockdown, didn't we? Like, everyone was watching Tiger King, everyone was baking, everyone was working on their garden, everyone was decorating their bedroom. Like, we went through all these phases, and it seemed like everybody did. And I'm glad I've got these pictures in my album to document all of that. I've also put in photos that other people sent me. So for example, this is a picture of one of our nieces. She finished a puzzle that we got her, I think it was for Christmas, and it was like a 1,000-piece puzzle. So it was a big one, and she's only 8, and she finally finished it. So our brother-in-law sent us a picture of her looking very proud with her puzzle. So I wanted to put that in as well, and it stops the album looking too samey with just all the same photos from our house. We've got an insight into other people's lives during lockdown as well, and I just really appreciate that. But it is something that I do quite often anyway. You often see other people's photos pop up in my albums, pictures that family have sent us and stuff. So I double-checked the date of Easter Sunday this year, and it was April the 12th. I'm not sure if that's exactly when those photos were taken, because I film on my phone, so I can't go back and check. But I figured I would have posted them on April the 12th anyway, so I stamped that. And then I'm just using that Let's Stay Home collection to add a few more stickers and embellishments here and there. And then we move on to the right-hand side of the page. So I'm starting with this photo of me and the dogs out in the garden. We were so lucky during this time. The weather was absolutely beautiful, so I basically just sat out in the garden every day. But I remember this particular day was really difficult. We were sort of coming to realise that the wedding probably wasn't going to happen, and I was really struggling with it. Because we were stuck inside at this time, we couldn't go out apart from to go to the supermarket or whatever, and I wasn't going out anyway because I was shielding. But because we couldn't go out, it was just all I could think about. It was like all consuming, and I was very upset, obviously, and that really sticks in my mind. So I remember that that photo was taken on that exact day, and again, I'll go back and double check the date and stamp it in a minute. But that little quote sticker is from the Let's Stay Home collection, and it says something like, "Don't give up, because better days are coming," that sort of thing. This one is of a completed creative journal that I finished during lockdown, and that sticker says scrapbooking, and then I'm just adding love on the top, so it says love scrapbooking, because I do, and I love a finished journal, so obviously I had to document that. This is just another garden tea photo, because like I say, all I did was sit out in the garden and read and drink tea. And honestly, it was actually really nice. Like, it's something that I want to make more time for when the weather is good, because it really lifted my mood to be outside. Then I have this baking together card, and I'm just documenting how I totally fell in love with banana muffins during lockdown, and that I baked them over and over and over again. And I'd never like baked anything before, but I just got obsessed with it during lockdown. And it had a little white baking mixer on the card, and the exact same shaped embellishment came in this collection in like a mint, so I just stuck that over the top. And then on the picture of the muffins, I've just added a little like oven mitt and a sticker that says do what you can, because that's what we were all doing at the time, whatever we could to keep ourselves occupied and to try and feel productive. This is a photo of the little champagne flutes that I ordered for my bridal party. They arrived during this time, and I was just writing a note that I had tried to stay positive and keep planning the wedding as if it was going to happen. And I wanted to document that they had arrived, because who knows if they will ever get used at this point. This is a photo that Will's sister sent us of her three boys enjoying the sunshine in the garden. And again, I just popped that in there because it's an insight into other people's lives, and it's not just entirely about us in this album. And then these were flowers that my brother and his fiance left on the doorstep when I was having a particularly bad day stressing about the wedding and stuff. And yeah, that is it, pretty much finished, I think, for this layout. I think I just go and stamp the date, and that's it. So this is a close look at the first page. That there's a rainbow on the other side card was from Let's Stay Home as well. And then we will go on to the right hand side. So I really hope you've enjoyed this video, guys. If you have any questions, let me know. I'm hoping to get back into crafting videos every week again, and I will see you in my next one. Have a great day, everyone. Bye.